So I have my sensor, and you can actually go through all your old readings, which is really nice just by hitting this button. I did have the Bluetooth version, but I could not get it to connect to Bluetooth. So this is only my third day using this sensor because I returned it for a non-Bluetooth version. It comes with, and I ordered extra blood strips. These are called test strips, the ketone test strips, and then sterile lancets. And I'm going to show you how to put it in here. So it comes with your little, I don't even know what this is called. But you put your lancet in here. You're going to feel like it's barely in there, which is fine. And then just twist this off. And you can see it has a little needle there. And then I'm going to just put the cap on. I put mine at a 5. You can see the little arrow thing here that punctures the most. And that works well for me. So it's 1 through 5. When you want to get this ready, the lancet ready to poke you, you're going to pull this back, and then you'll see it's red right here on the release button. And I'm using my own terms, not according to the book. There is a book that goes through this, which is how I learned to do this. I advise you to obviously read that. But that is how you are going to get your lancet ready to puncture your finger. Now I'm going to get my sensor ready. So there are expiration dates on here to make sure you're using one that still works. And I'll show you how. So you put this black and white end in and facing up. And you can see my sensor is evaluating it, and it tells me it's ready for blood. So I'm just going to set that down. And then I like to go at the side of my finger. So I'm going to just put it right on there, hit the release button. It's a little scary getting used to it, but it really does not hurt. I'm just pushing my finger so that you can see the blood coming out. And then you don't want to come from the side. You want to go directly into the blood and let it hold there for 8 minutes. You can see it'll start counting down, or 8 seconds, excuse me. Okay, so my ketone reading is very high. I've only been fasting for 18 and a half hours, but that's how you use it. I have not had a ketone reading above 1.6 yet, so a 3.4 is crazy. But this is how you use it. I feel like this ketone reader is very, I don't have like lab tests to run it against or anything else. But when I'm not doing keto and I fast, my numbers are lower. I'm going to share my results for, it's going to be about 35 days worth of results, blood test results, when I'm fasting and not doing keto, and then 28 days worth of keto, and then a few more days of fasting without keto, and just to evaluate the results. But when I tested this on my husband, who is not a faster, and he had recently had a hot chocolate, it said it was low, so there were no ketones even to note. Okay, but that's how you use it. It's super simple. So then I take this out, and you can hit the power button, or it just powers off on its own. And then I log mine in a calendar. And they also actually have an app. I will pop that up on the screen. And the app, you can manually log it if you don't have the Bluetooth like I don't. If you have Bluetooth, it'll automatically send it to your app. I don't have Bluetooth, and I choose not to log it manually. I'm just writing it in a calendar, but I might do that. But there is an app. And as I mentioned, I originally paid the $10 extra to get the Bluetooth, but it wouldn't work. I use Bluetooth all the time. I use it very regularly on my iPhone. I use it on my MacBook. I use it on my old laptop, and I even tested it on my husband's phone, and none of them could find the ketone sensor. And it also gave me an E7 code, which is a Bluetooth error. So I just sent it back. I didn't have time to try to figure it out and ordered the non-keto one. So I kept using the one without Bluetooth until this one arrived. So simple, I definitely recommend it. And the test strips are a little expensive, but in my opinion, they're worth it. If you're interested, I have an affiliate link below. I am not associated with a company. They don't know I exist, but I'm just sharing with you what I chose to buy and what I'm using for my experiment of my keto challenge. And so far, I have really enjoyed this, and I actually like the data. I think I will continue to use this in my fasting journey as I am changing my eating windows and maybe doing low carb every once in a while. We'll see what comes of this trial, but I actually really like having the data. I think it's quite interesting. And as a data person, more is better. So make sure you check that out below. If you're a data person and you want to see some of my early zero and Renfo information with my daily weighing and my daily eating windows, you can check out this video right here. Thank you so much for watching. Chow down and chow.